Atlantia vivere. Nothing is true and everything is permitted, my friends. Why do I say this? This is the creed or the logo of the Assassin's Creed. I am the leader of the Assassins here in Romania. I was kept under guard and in great pains because I made the mistake towards Diana, which is a fellow assassin, a ranking assassin. I'm a master assassin. And my lieutenant placed in front of me some orders of executions of the main Illuminati leaders. And I refused to sign them out of consideration for their own lives for 2 years, for 1.5 years, from 22nd of February 2013 till today. But now I have stamped and signed them. You know, before I will move forward, I wish to explain what does this mean. Nothing is true and everything is permitted. When we say nothing is true, we mean that we must always act in good faith. And we must, when we say that everything is permitted, we actually say that we must also respond for our own actions. We must take responsibility for our own actions. Why? Because it is said, for millennia people in the church have lied to their fellow believers. But we know that nothing is true. Also, for thousands of years governments have imposed limits on human freedom. But we know that everything is permitted. So, our Assassin's Creed has three tenets. The first tenet is be a blade in the night, always be discreet. Be a shadow kill, be a shadow killer. Hide in plain sight, hide in plain sight. Why? Because you can, you must always be discreet, you must blend with the crowd. And you must also only target and kill your target. You must not kill the other people around them. You must not kill civilians. Those are innocent bystanders, because our second tenet say, stay your blade from the blood of the innocent. So by always be discreet, ensure your safety and the safety of others. You can hide a knife beneath a handkerchief. Or two handkerchiefs. You can, if someone wishes to shoot you, you can say, yes, you're an innocent person, and then cut his throat while being on the left or on the right or on up or down upon the direction to which he is intending to fire. You must move quickly, left, right, or jump up and then kill him. With a knife, with a blade in one of his eyes or something like that. Or you can slide beneath his legs and cut his throat from behind. But when he is ready to fire, when he fires, you must not be on the direction of his bullet. Well, you have to understand that the guards, the guardsmen, the policemen, the spies, are innocent people. I recently said that my recent humiliation of 13th of August 2014 at Dracula's place to a CIA agent, that he's an innocent man. He's an innocent tool of this deception. We are not innocent because we know what we are doing. Also, the Illuminati leaders, which are located in Geneva, in Rome, in London, in Londinium, in our city of London, in Washington DC, they are not innocent. They know what they are doing. Some people suggested that I should send 4 nuclear bombs and detonate, but that will mean killing too many people. On the other hand, this means putting more of our own lives, the lives of the assassins, at risk. You should stay away from fire. If you employ fire guns, you should use silencers. You should be discreet. So if it is possible, you must also always put your life first. But if it is possible to not kill those guardsmen, those policemen, those spies, then do not kill them, only harm or incapacitate them. You can choke them behind their back, you can quickly twist their head, and then they will get paralyzed. You can... So, you have your targets, Colonel. But before I move on, to say I was afraid for my own life for saying this publicly, but not anymore. Why? Because my life now is not worth living. I have so much pains, and Lorenzo Marin, that fucking spy, told me that I will not be paid, that my life feels now void of any meaning. My good years have passed. In 2009, 2008, and now the sick old men of Romania are taking advantage of me and making me a fool, and I don't want to be their fool. So, in this gerontocracy, we have this. Yes, they have many crazy rules that no more teasing, you know, they will humiliate me, no more legs, no more hand, no more ears, no more, no more spine. Yes, no more spine, and they will prevent me from getting paid, from getting medical attention. They will seek to destroy me and kill me in order to maintain their control over me, that, but they will fail. So, I do not believe. Lorenzo Marin has no right to decide upon my work and my life. Why do I decide upon the life of others? Well, because the entire Illuminati leadership needs to be decapitated, destroyed. I will tell you now the story of the water and fire. Dacia told me I am like fire, and I said, well, I am like water. Why? Because she's the Empress, the leader of Lemuria, and I'm the leader of Atlantis. And you know, Atlantia, I will tell you the true story of the water, because water has a spirit, and fire has a spirit, and earth has a spirit, and wind has a spirit. Air, earth, fire, and water are the four elements of nature. The fifth is the ether. The ether. So, in the beginning, water was without life, but the Supreme God saw the beauty of the water and sent his divine ghost or divine spirit to enter the water. So water became a living soul, and water said, we are many and we are one. There are many drops, but there is only one river. There are many rivers, but there is only one sea. There are many seas, but there is only one ocean. When a drop of water falls into the ocean, it becomes the ocean. And when it separates, the ocean becomes a drop. So the thoughts of the white race are in my mind. The ocean is in the drop, and the drop is in the ocean. The power of water is great, my friends. Silently she works, day by day, moment by moment, night by night, and crushes the stone. It slowly works and digs at the edge, lower, when you cannot be, when you cannot see, and then the rock collapses, and the river has open path. And when the river has open path, all the water with great anger flows upon the entire universe and floods it. But after that, the water comes down and becomes sweet again. Be like water, my son. Bend, but never break. Be like a weed in the air. When the strong wind comes, you must bend and fold your knees and ask forgiveness from your enemies. But then, when the great wind no longer flows, you must stand up and destroy your enemies and be strong again. Never break. Be like water. Work all the time. Be strong, my son, Luciano. So, Seeing this grace flooding the Supreme God also sent his divine spirit into fire, and fire became a great spirit, and then a living soul, and then the fire started to burn up a planet and many stars and many galaxies. And when the water of Atlantia has flooded 120,000 galaxies, the fire has also burned 180,000 galaxies. But the water calms the fire, and the fire evaporates the water. You see, my friends. So the two contraries have met, Lemuria and Atlantis, Atlantia and Lemuria, and they have formed a great union of 340,000 galaxies. But after that, the insect came. And so the water and fire descended on this planet, my head, and became the white race and the red race. The spirit of Atlantia is a woman, so a man must lead Atlantia, while the spirit of Lemuria is a man, so a woman must lead Lemuria. Women are the power in Lemuria, and men are the power in Atlantis. So by the great union of the white string and the red string at the 1st of March, the great union of Apollo and the white one, and the Artemis, the red one, the divine twins, I was struck in my head and became crazy. She was struck in her belly and was unable to carry children. But soon I will meet my own sister, and soon the water and the fire shall be again complete. And the energy of our touch, because we must touch our fingers, like in the 4D continuum, shall stop that asteroid. And like the wind of the yellow race and the stone and earth of the black race collide, so we must collide. But after that, we make sex. And so it begins.